Hi, welcome to ChemSimplified. Do you need to find different functional groups present in a complex compound? You've come to the right place. In this video, we are going to be identifying multiple functional groups in compound using three examples. We'll start easy and work our way up. Sounds good? I've posted several videos introducing the 13 functional groups. The link is at the top and in the description box below. Do check it out to get more info on how to differentiate each of these groups. Let's start with the first compound, aspirin. It's commonly used to treat pain and reduce fever or inflammation. Sometimes it's also used as a therapy to lower the risk of heart attack. So, how many functional groups do you see in aspirin? Try looking for anything that is not single bonded carbon and hydrogen. Here's what I see, three groups. Did you get these? Or did you actually get four groups? Or maybe five? If you did get four or five, I'm gonna address that soon. So hang in there. Let's go back to the three that I have circled. So the first group on the top there, C double bond OOH. So the functional group is called carboxylic acid. And then on the bottom there, we have six membered ring, meaning we have six carbon in a ring, alternating double single double single double single bond. So that's a benzene ring, and we call that group arene. And to the right, the last group, you have a C double bond O, and next to it is a O which is connected to a carbon, so you have COOC. That is an ester. So back to that four groups or that five groups that you may have circled. Did you do this? Did you split out that COOH into two groups and call it ketone and alcohol? And did you also do the same for this, where you have COC and you call that ether, and C double bond O, you call it ketone? If you've done that, take note that you should not be doing that. If you see a carbonyl group like C double bond O, and right next to that C double bond O, there is an oxygen or there's a nitrogen, so they should be grouped together. So in our case, for aspirin, we have carboxylic acid and ester, and the third one, arene. Next, our second compound, capsaicin. That's the stuff you find in chili peppers, the one that's responsible in producing the burning sensation when you eat it. All right, so how many groups do you see? I have five. Going from left to right, this is what I have. Did you get those or did you get six? If you get six, we're gonna address it. It's the same issue like the first one. So starting from left to right, that's ether, carbon, oxygen, carbon. And on the top there, that's a alcohol because of that OH group. And this third one we've seen before in the previous example, that's an arene, six-membered ring, alternating single double bond. And then we have this group called amide. C double bond O right next to a nitrogen. That's an amide. And last but not least, that's an alkene. C double bond C. So these are our five groups for capsaicin. Now, if you got six groups, this is what you may have done. Splitting them into NH and C double bond O, calling it amine and ketone. So like I've said in the first compound, if you see these two groups right next to each other, go ahead and group them together. So it should be amide. How do you feel? Pretty confident? Now let's move on to our final example. That's PiCC. Are you horrified? Well, don't be. Let's take it slow and let's scan from left to right, like what we've been doing the past two examples, and we'll figure out one group at a time. So starting from the bottom left, I see an OH group, so that's our alcohol. Moving on, I see two lines above it. That's C double bond C. And in fact, if you look closely, it's all over the place. You have it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 more. So that is our C double bond C alkene. Okay, so back to the left of the compound, next to the double bonds, I see a nitrogen. And that nitrogen has three bonds. Two to carbon and one to hydrogen. So that's our amine. Do you see another amine in this compound? Yep, That's the one. So what about this guy? The one on the right. Is that an amine? Nope. That's actually an amide. We talked about this in the previous compound. All right, not bad. We are halfway there. Okay, move back to the left of the compound again. Let's look at the top. What do you see? C double bond OH. So that's an aldehyde. And right next to it, we have a COOH. That's a carboxylic acid. Moving down to the center of the compound, we have C double bond O. And to the left and right of it are carbons. So that is a ketone. And the last one that we have here is this guy here. COOCH3. So if you were to draw it out, it would look like this. C double bond O. And next to it is an oxygen. And next to that oxygen is a carbon with three hydrogens in our example. So that is an example of ester. So here's our cleaned up labels for the 8 different functional groups present in PiCC. That ends our practice on identifying multiple functional groups in organic compounds. If you enjoy this video and feel that it is helpful in showing you how to recognize multiple functional groups, do give it a thumbs up and share it with anyone you feel will benefit from it. Also, do subscribe and click on that bell icon so you'll get notified on new videos. Please head over to chemsimplified.com for more info on this topic. I'll post the blog link in the description box. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.